Hello, I am Flash Isaac. This is Flash Nenas. You are now watching 120 Days to Jam. This is a series containing 120 videos to prepare you for Jam. Each episode of the series contains introduction, outline, detailed class, questions, and homework for you. The questions and homework are from the Flash Learners Jam application. Install Flash Learners Jam app today to access all the free features. Click activate and scroll to buy activation key to get access to the golden features. Don't be scared, the app is affordable. Do you have trust issues? Simply chat me directly on Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, and Telegram for installation and activation instruction. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time to take off. Episode number 7 of the 120 Days to Jam Economics with Flash Isaac. This class is an appetizer to introduce you to calculations in economics. And when you hear calculations, fear should not romance your mind. Relax, Flash Isaac got you covered. I will explain the calculation questions in ways that will be very sweet to you. And I will make sure that when it comes to economics, you now prefer calculations to the theoretical part. I will do that. So just free your mind and be happy. This episode and a couple of next episodes shall focus on the methods of economics analysis. The methods we employ to analyze economics. And Jam expects you to know scientific approach and basic tools so long the method of economic analysis is concerned. In episode 1, I explain the scientific method, which are divided into inductive and deductive reasoning, positive and normative reasoning. I summarize that, or in summary, deductive reasoning is a type of reasoning where we draw conclusion from premises or from fact. From a whole, we draw conclusion. From general, we draw specific conclusion. From generalization to specific. If John looks like Luke, and Luke looks like Abel, it therefore means that John looks like Abel. From the premises, we arrive at conclusion. Inductive reasoning, on the other hand, goes from specific to general. From the basic data collected, you generalize. Matthew is a student. He cheats. John is a student. He cheats in the exam hall. Luke is a student. He cheats in the exam hall. Abel is a student. He cheats in the exam hall. Prosper is a student. He cheats in the exam hall. Tyson is a student. He cheats in the exam hall. Efe is a student. He cheats in the exam hall. Therefore, all students cheat in the exam hall. So from the small data you gathered, you generalize all the students. So did you go to other school? Or if you check the schools in your state, did you go to other states? If you check the ones in your country, did you go to other places? So using your small fact to generalize, that is inductive reasoning. That is an inductive reasoning. So positive reasoning is a reasoning that concerns itself with what is. What is the state of Nigeria? What is the economy of Nigeria? What is happening in Nigeria? What happened in Nigeria last year? What happened to the economy last 2 years? What do you think the economy will be next year? What is, what was, what should be? But normative economy concerns itself with what should be. It has concern with moral values. Yes, what should Nigeria be doing? Should Nigeria take loan to buy mosquito nets? Should this be done? So that is normative economy. So all that already explained in the first episode. Now, basic economics tools. The tools we use in economics are tables, charts, graphs, charts, bar chart, pie chart, histogram, component bar chart, multiple bar chart, graphs, plotting of graphs. Then central tendency is divided into mean, median,
and mood. Now, skewness. In a normal distribution, the mean and mode are the same. Even medium, they are the same. What you see here, this is a normal distribution. The mean, median, and mode are the same. Therefore, in this normal distribution, there is zero skewness, no skewness. The mean is equals the mode. But it gets to a point where values begin to deviate from the mean position. Values begin to deviate from the mean position. So, that deviation from the mean position or from the normal distribution is what we refer to as skewness. You see here, this we are seeing here, this is a skew. Here is another skew. We refer to this as positive skewness. Here is negative skew. Positive skew, it has long tail to the right. You see, here is bigger. Then as you go to the right, here get smaller. For negative skewness, it has long tail to the right. You see this tail is long to the right. Then the other side gets bigger. So, from here, can we say the mean is bigger than the mode? For positive skewness, the mean is bigger than the mode. For negative skew, the mean is lesser than the mode. Or the mode is greater than the mean. And mean is an average number. If I give you 2, 3, 1 to look for the mean, it is simply adding these three numbers and dividing by how many they are. That is 2 plus 3 plus 1 over how many are they? 1, 2, 3 over 3. This is 6 over 3 and that is 2. That is the mean. If I give you these three numbers, the median is the middle number after you've arranged the number orderly. Here, let's start from smallest to the biggest. 1, 2, 3. The median is these two, the middle number. The mode is number that appears the most if you have so many numbers. The measure of dispersion, we deal with range, variance, mean deviation, and standard deviation. All these are what JAMB expects you to know under methods of economics analysis. And for your assignment, you open your FlashEnerz JAMB app, go to question search and search deductive reasoning, inductive reasoning separately, answer the questions, positive reasoning, or search scientific approach generally and answer the questions as a means of revision for episode 1. Then for these basic tools and charts, we shall deal with them in episode 8, 9, and 10. You see questions that will interest you, answers that will motivate you. The aim is for you to score very, very high and to fall in love with economics, especially the calculation aspect. It is a crime to end this class without questions from the FlashEnerz JAMB app. The first question here says, a distribution is said to be positively skewed if dash A has long tail to the left. Long tail to the left. Positive skewed. Positive long tail to the no. Has long tail to the right. Yes. Positive skew has long tail to the right. Negative has long tail to the left. So option B is correct. Which of these is a measure of central tendency? The measure of central tendency are mean, median, and mode. So out of all these, only median is a measure of central tendency. So option D is the correct option. Ladies and gentlemen, this brings us to the end of this episode. Relax, eat well, and prepare for the next set of episodes. You're gonna enjoy them. Thank you.